bilgilerini yapacağım. Sanata inanılmaz bir iz bırakmış öncü bir akımın yaratıcılarından biriyle beraberiz.
Well, since many years, I'm interested in Oriental art, in historical Oriental art, of course. And there's a reason for this, because Oriental art is totally non-figurative. And art in the Occident is mainly figurative and full of expressionism. For these people, they did little illustrations and miniature pictures, and there you will see some figures. But all in all, Oriental art depends on structures, and a very important and general well-known structure is the ornament. This principle of an ornament and this principle of repetition of one single idea, very important for Oriental art, and it goes up to arabesque and to the calligraphic work. And that goes along with a large part of my work, because my work is not a kind of abstraction. It's really depending on itself. It's a reference given by itself to each piece. What's really amazing, what's really surprising and unexpected, that nowadays the modern technique in the nature, in the science of nature, is depending on the microscope. And this is a very special microscope. It works with a grid, a filter, and it goes down to atomic structures. So what a scientist working for the nature or in nature tasks, he is depending on the computer. Afterwards, what he has seen in the microscope will be transformed in a computer to a visual report, so you can imagine how things are modeled of the world, not seen by tourists going through the landscape. All this is very beautiful, of course, that's nature too. But nowadays, the subject of experiments and the subject of research of natural science goes through the microscope. And they work with structures. And that's the same what happens to the Oriental art. The Oriental art is really a kind of art which does not depend on a special form, like your nice body. It is depending on the structure. And if you have a big arabesque, it's one logical structure of one idea, which is really always done in repetition and comes up to a kind of network somehow, in terms of visual network. So, to give a short comment to my relation to Oriental art. I don't depend on a very special material. There are artists around, they really depend on one material. For instance, wood or stainless steel or whatever. But in my case, I prefer and I like to use different material. But then I have to try to learn the language and the character of such a material. If I don't understand the inner structure of this material, I cannot work with it. If I work with a stone, the stone does not have any life. It's a dead piece. And I try to give a certain surface to the stone, and at least I even polish the surface, so the light can work with this polished surface. The sense of it is, if I do such a lot of work of polishing and all this, I want to immaterialize the material. come up to a very new apparition. So that means to dematerialize the surface of the material.